recommend hymn number 589.
Thank you.
this morning is from Genesis chapter 18. The Lord appeared to Abraham by the oaks of Mamre, as he sat in the door of his tent in the heat of the day. He lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, three men were standing in front of him. When he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them, and bowed himself to the earth, and said, O Lord, if I have found favor in your sight, do not pass by your servant. Let a little water be brought, and wash your feet, and rest yourselves under the tree, while I bring a morsel of bread, that you may refresh yourselves, and after that you may pass on, since you have come to your servant. So they said, Do as you have said. And Abraham went quickly into the tent to Sarah and said, Quick, three seahs of fine flour, knead it, and make cakes. And Abraham ran to the herd and took a calf, tender and good, and gave it to a young man who prepared it quickly. Then he took curds and milk and the calf that he had prepared and set it before them. And he stood by them under the tree while they ate. They said to him, Where is Sarah your wife? He said, She is in the tent. The Lord said, I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah your wife shall have a son. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
Epistle from Colossians chapter 1. You who once were alienated and hostile in mind, who in evil deeds, he has now reconciled in his body of flesh by his death, in order to present you holy and blameless and above reproach before him. If indeed you continue in the faith, stable and steadfast, not shifting from the hope of the gospel that you heard, which has been proclaimed in all creation under heaven, and which I, Paul, became a minister. Now I rejoice in my suffering for your sake, and in my flesh I am filling up what is lacking in Christ's afflictions for the sake of his body, that is the church, of which I am a minister, according to the stewardship from God that was given to me for you to make the word of God fully known. Mystery hidden for ages and generations, but now revealed to the saints. Them God chose to make known how great among the Gentiles are the riches of the glory of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Him we proclaim, warning everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom, that we may present everyone mature in Christ. For this I toil, struggling with all energy that he powerfully works within me. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
You please rise to the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, in the 10th chapter. Now as they went on their way, Jesus entered the village, and a woman named Martha welcomed him into her house. She had a sister called Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teaching. But Martha was distracted with much serving. And she went up to him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Tell her then to help me. The Lord answered her, Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things, but one thing is necessary. Mary has chosen the good portion, which will not be taken away from her. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
Forever, O Lord, your word is firmly set in the heavens. Down, for it is written, He will command His angels concerning you, and on their hands hands, they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against the stone. Jesus said to him, again, it is written, you shall not put the Lord your God to the test. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. He said to him, all these I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. Then Jesus said to him, be gone, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve. Then the devil left him, and behold, angels came and were ministering to him. At this time, I invite our children forward for our children's message.
Thank you.
mother-in-law was ill with a high fever, and they appealed to him on her behalf. And he stood over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. And immediately she rose and began to serve them. Now when the sun was setting, all those who had any who were sick and with various diseases brought them to him, and he laid his hands on every one of them and healed them. And demons also came out of many, crying, "You are the Son of God." But he rebuked them and would not allow them to speak, because they knew that he was the Christ. And when it was day, he departed and went into a desolate place, and the people saw him and came to him and would have kept him from leaving them. But he said to them, "I must preach the good news of the kingdom of God to the other towns as well, for I was sent for this purpose." And he was preaching in the synagogues of Judea. Here ends the rest of our text for this morning. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the very power of God's Word. As we've seen here in our texts, we've seen Satan had no choice but to leave. Illness cannot stand before Almighty God. There is nothing that can stand before Him as He proclaims these words to it or to them. That is the power of God's Word. That is why St. Paul talks about the power of the gospel. See, we also have been given this Word to proclaim the truth. Because this world is not our heritage. It is not what we are looking forward to. Rather, we are seeking first His kingdom. As Jesus reminds us in Matthew 6, we are to seek first the kingdom of God, and everything else that he was talking about before, clothing and food and so forth, will be taken care of. Because the Lord is watching over His people. No matter what the situation might be, whether it's sickness, illness, or disease, whether it's having great wealth or not having enough wealth or whatever it might be, when we put Him first, then everything is as it is going to be. I know that is a challenge sometimes when we look at our checkbooks and go, "Lord, it's almost the end and we've got this bill, and of course at that point in time the refrigerator dies, the stove dies, or whatever else it is, and there's no guarantee or warranty anymore. What are we going to do?" We get to trust in Him. That's why God has given us His Word. Just as I said to the children, He uses it three times in our Matthew text. Or even more so in our Luke text. As God of all creation speaks His Word. Jesus barely speaks, and Peter's mother-in-law is healed. He heals the demon-possessed, those who have other diseases. And Satan cannot remain before Him. All of this takes place because of His care for us. When you think about it, if Jesus didn't care, He wouldn't have come. But He did come. He came and died and rose. And we know it in Scripture. Because He's the one that says to us, "Are we not worth more than birds?" Right? And the sparrows? Two for a penny, right? They're nothing. They're just birds. I know, don't those stones yet. But the point is they're just birds. We're humans. God cares for us, which is why Jesus died for us. There is no one else to go to. There is only Him who has given us this Word that we put our faith, hope, and trust in. God does love His creation. We know all of Scripture tells us, right? Romans, Paul reminds us that all of creation is groaning because it has been subject to what? To suffering because of man's sin. Thorns and thistles weren't supposed to be thorns and thistles in the way they are now. Animals and humans were supposed to be in harmony with one another. This was perfection. But it was destroyed. It was ruined. And the devil knows exactly what to do to push the buttons of us. To drive us to sin. That's why we struggle each day with the things that we know are around us. Our own sinful flesh is not even for us. But Christ is. See, that's why even when Jesus heals those who are demon-possessed, he tells the demons to be quiet. He rebukes them. Even in our Matthew text. In a sense, that's what he's doing to Satan. Rebuking them. They cannot remain to speak. Because the devil and the demons are liars. They do not speak the truth. Scripture calls the devil the father of lies. There is no hope there. We submit ourselves to Christ. Because the devil himself will not do that. Remember, he's judged. We know that because when we get to the end of the story in the book of Revelation, he's cast into the lake of fire forever. There is no hope even now for him nor those who follow him. Because nothing can stand in opposition to Christ. The devil or anything else created cannot stand in opposition to him. The sick and the demonic are cured because Jesus is God. And what happens, though, even in this life, if one isn't cured? What happens if that disease ends in death? Lord, really, they were children of God. They believed in the word that he has given to us. And that is a blessing. Not saying it's not easy, because it isn't. Not saying it's difficult, because it is difficult to lose a loved one in death. But we also know the comfort of the peace of those who have gone before us in suffering. Jesus lives for his creation, for us. He lives because he is alive. Right? It's great words of the angel there in the tomb. Are you looking for the living among the dead? See, those words the angel uses, the words that Christ uses, the words that we use are God's words. Oh, they don't change this, they don't change that. We're talking that way. We're talking about preaching and teaching and proclaiming to one another what Christ has given us. His words. Lifting one another up in prayer. Knowing that that is what God has called us to do. Knowing that even as Jesus is now going into the synagogue here in Luke, what's he doing? He's there to proclaim, I must preach the gospel, the good news of the kingdom of God to the other towns as well. For I was sent for this purpose. See, as Jesus goes about his ministry, it's all leading up to the cross. That's why there is only one gospel. Remember, Paul says, if even an angel should come down and proclaim to you a different gospel from the one you heard, meaning Jesus' death and resurrection for us, let him be anathema. there's only one true message. There's only one true gospel. Because there is only one God. That's it. One God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. There is no competing message. Now, see, wait a minute. There's a lot of competing words, right? There's only one gospel. Because the world does not know Christ unless the church proclaims Him. My friends, people talk about the fact that they can know God when they're on the golf course, or in the boat, or camping, or whatever it might be. I don't want to touch that. Camping, or anything. It's only through the Word of God that we see Christ. The world does not show us Jesus. It is only His Word that proclaims Him. That's what it means to serve only one God, to have only one gospel. I said it before, I'll say it again, there's only one religion that has the gospel, and that is Christianity. That's why we must get that message out, so that others will stop trying to make themselves right before God. They won't. They can't. They can repent, but they can't make themselves right before God. So there is confession. This very fact of the Word of God is confessed, because there's no confusion of salvation either. Jesus doesn't say, well, I'm going to go to these people, I'm going to tell them this, or I'm going to go to these people and tell them something different. Nope. I must preach the good news of the kingdom of God to other towns as well, for I was sent for this purpose. One message. One Savior. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. That's why there's no doubt when it comes to our salvation. Because we don't have to go, gee, what does He mean by this? He tells us right here. Over and over again of what it means to be a child of God, trusting in Him. Knowing that the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, is already present. Jesus living in us and for us, granting us His Spirit, who proclaims with words our Savior. So today, we hear. We hear because the words have been spoken to us that Jesus Christ is Lord, your King, my King, your Savior, my Savior, Jesus. In His name, amen. Could you please rise as we join together this morning to sing of the day?
Thank you.
people have gathered once again in your house, giving you thanks and praise that through the word that you have given to us, your Son, Jesus Christ, we may now proclaim his word into the hearts of our new lives, and we may proclaim it also one amongst ourselves to each other. Father, be a blessing to us and the congregation here in this place, that we may truly proclaim the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, and that others may have the joy that we have as well. Father, we ask that you will be with those in our prayers this day. We ask that you will be with Lloyd Rinker as he is in hospital. Gracious Lord, be a blessing to him and to his family. Keep him in your care. Allow the doctors to use their skills to their highest ability. Father, we thank you for Floyd Storm as he's now continuing his rehabilitation in Heartland. Gracious Lord, be a blessing to your servant and keep him. Father, we ask that you'll be with Veronica Prosser as she is going to have surgery once again. Be watching over your little one and keep her in your care. Give blessings to her parents as well as they travel back and forth and the rest of those families who travel back and forth to be with them. Father, we give you thanks for Larry Lenz who had surgery this past week also. We ask that you'll be with him as he's recuperating at home now, that you'll be a blessing to him and allow him to recuperate to be a speedy and successful one. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you with Allison and Jake McElwain for the birth of young Griffin. Gracious Heavenly Father, be with this family, keeping this little one in your care, as only you can do. Father, we ask that you will be with the family of Roy Reed Jr. as his death this past week. Gracious Lord, we want to keep them, as also only you can do. Father, we also pray that you will be with all those who are traveling today and or tomorrow to the Central by District Convention. That we may do your work that you call us to do as your church in this district, and that we may give you thanks and praise as we continue on with the president who will be elected this day also, tomorrow rather, that you will be a blessing to our new president, as well as to our president, President Miller, as he is leaving office. Father, we ask that you will also continue to be with our synodical president, as well as our circuit leader. Gracious Heavenly Father, we ask that you will be with the president, our Congress, governor of our state, legislature, the mayor of our village, and its board. Father, we ask that you also continue to be with all those who serve us in the military, all the different branches, be a blessing to them, keeping them as only you can do. Gracious Father, we thank you and praise you for those that even know prayers in our hearts, knowing that you hear and that you answer. For all these things, we give you thanks and praise in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We join together now the singing of the Kyrie. Righteous in your sight, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lived and reigned.